I love how God's word can anchor us to what we are needing to do, the principles and understanding the kingdom, but also how the Holy Spirit gives us the details and the directions. I know back, we have 6 grandchildren at this time, and when our second one was coming, I certainly did not want to miss the birth of our second daughter's little baby. And so I was like, no, I'm not going to go on this trip that we'd won. And that trip was, it was a trip to Costa Rica. It was very, very nice. All expenses paid.
Yeah, and you love the beach.
Yeah.
It was an awesome trip.
And I wanted to see those monkeys, those howler monkeys and all those other things.
Yeah, the monkeys down there.
But the dilemma was the trip was only one particular week, and that week was the week that our second grandchild
right,
was
in
due.
In the middle of the week.
And I'm too much of a grandma and a mommy. I'm not missing that grandchild being born. And so we were registered for the trip, but I just did not feel like I could go on it. And Gary actually was seeking God in prayer. We were praying. We were both praying about it. But you heard something from the Holy Spirit that helped us, you know.
Well, it's one of those kind of situations that maybe you're facing today that you have to know. I mean, there's one thing to do and another not. You've got to know what thing to do.
Right. And if you make the wrong decision, it could be like you're going to miss something.
Yeah. And so I was praying in the Spirit. I exercised in the morning, and I was just praying in the Spirit for a couple of days in a row. And the second day I was praying, the Lord spoke to me and gave me the exact date that baby would be born, which was 2 days after the end of this trip. And I came home excited, said, Drenda, the Lord said to go on that trip, that baby will be born 2 days after we get back. And we got home. Of course, the baby was born 2 days after
because,
we got back.
And because I trust you spiritually, I kept saying to him, I trust you. I trust
you.
Are you sure? I trust you. And sure enough, it was exactly to the day what the Holy Spirit showed Gary. And had we not heard that, we would have missed a wonderful trip. We would have been back here waiting. The baby would have been born, you know, 2 days after. We would have thought, darn, we missed that trip. We could have gone. Or, like you said, we could have gone on the trip and been anxious. But I had perfect peace.
That's right.
That you'd heard that. And it bore witness with my spirit as well. But in the natural, we start to argue things in our mind. So our mind is trying to analyze everything.
Right.
And the Gary, how do you know whether it's your mind that you're getting this from, or how do you know it's the Holy Spirit? Because I know that can be confusing.
I'm glad you asked that. That's a great question we can dig into right now. How does this actually operate? To understand this, the first thing you need to understand is your three parts. You have a spirit, the God part of you, your soul realm, your mind, will, and emotions, and you live in a body. That, you need to have that. And we're going to talk out of 1 Corinthians, the 2nd chapter, verse number 7. Now, Paul is writing here, and he says, no, we speak of God's secret wisdom. Notice the word secret wisdom, a wisdom that has been hidden and that God destined for our glory before time began. So Paul says there's a wisdom that needs to be hidden, but we need to answer who from. Well, it's not for us because he says it's destined for our glory. So it's, he explains here, none of the rulers of this age understood it, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. Vital principle here. He's talking about Satan and demons. If they pick up on the plan of God, they're going to try to intercept that plan. So Paul goes on and says, however, as it is written, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has conceived what God has prepared for those who love Him. Now, we've all heard that scripture before. Many times at funerals or people quote that. And certainly someone dies and goes to heaven. We don't have a concept of how great that's going to be. You know, it's going to be amazing. But it goes on and says, but God has revealed these things to us by His Spirit. What things has He revealed to us?
The direction.
Well, the things, we haven't heard, things we haven't seen, things we've not thought of. And that's what I need.
Yes.
I need a revelation of things I don't have a clue about.
Yes.
And the Bible says right here that by God's Spirit, He revealed these things. He has revealed these things to us. Now, it says the Spirit of God searches all things, even the deep things of God. For who among men know the thoughts of a man except the man's spirit within him? Now, this is a key principle. Your spirit and your thoughts, your mind, are so closely connected that you can't hardly discern the difference. In fact, Hebrews, referring to the Word of God, says, the Word of God is active and living, able to discern or divide between soul,
and
mind,
yes,
will, and emotions, and spirit. Mm. Because we have a trouble doing that. They're so closely tied together. Okay, so hold that. Now, in the same way, no one knows the thoughts of God except the Spirit of God. So catch this. God's Spirit obviously knows His thoughts. Our spirit knows our thoughts, closely tied together. Mm-hmm. When we're born again, the Spirit of God unites with our spirit as one. As God's Spirit, we're the temple of the Holy Spirit, indwells us, becomes part of our spirit, guess what we have access to?
God's Spirit.
God's Spirit, but God's thoughts.
Yes.
Thoughts, that's important. We've not received the Spirit from the world, but the Spirit of God who is from God, that we may understand what God has freely given to us. And this is what we speak, not in words taught us by human wisdom, or basically what we can discern, mm-hmm. eyes, ears, thoughts, but in words taught by the Holy Spirit. Catch this, words we speak, taught to us by the Holy Spirit, expressing spiritual truths in spiritual words. Now, the spiritual man, the man without the Spirit of God, it says, does not accept the things that come from the Spirit, for they're foolishness to him, and he cannot understand them because they're spiritually discerned. But here's our verse. I told you, I promised I'd give this to you. Verse 15, 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 15. The spiritual man makes judgments or has discernment about all things, but he himself is not subject to any man's judgment, meaning he's not subject or limited to man's judgment, man's ability to discern. He's not limited by that. So the Spirit of God in us, Drenda, knows all things. We have his thoughts, God's voice, he speaks to us, comes up out of our spirit, and we are able to discern or judge like that vacation. Now, just yesterday, speaking of vacations, we had a trip we were planning to go on. About a month from now, and the Holy Spirit said, no, don't go. And we canceled our plans. Mm-hmm. You say, well, why would you do that? Because he said, he led me to the direction. I was praying about it. We are not to go on that trip. So we're to be led in life. In fact, the Bible says that children of God are led in life by the Spirit of God. Now, the Spirit of God in us, his thoughts come into our spirit. I always say they kind of bubble up into our consciousness because our spirit's so closely tied to our thoughts. People say, what does God's voice sound like? It sounds like your thoughts with a different twang to it. It has a different sound to it, but it rises up as a thought, but it has a different sound to it. There's so much more we could cover along this topic, but of course, I really want people to get this book. The most essential thing you need after salvation is the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Because as you learn how to pray in the Spirit, Paul referenced spiritual words that the Holy Spirit teaches us how to pray. The Holy Spirit praying through us is revealed in the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Now, if you're like me, I never heard of that growing up. But I want to challenge you to check the Word of God out into what it says about this.
Yes, and I love it. It says, the Spirit himself makes intercession through us. Mm-hmm. When we don't even know the words to pray, we don't know the direction, the Spirit on the inside of us prays those words,
that's
spiritual
awesome.
Words that you read, when we don't know what to do or how to lead. And I've just seen so many times praying in the Spirit, and then right after that, knowing exactly what to do. Just boom, it hits us. And sometimes we can get so pressured in life trying to make a decision that you start to get under intense, this vacillating.
Confusion
is the right word. Mm-hmm. And I know for us, many times we would just start doing something else. We've been praying in the Spirit, start doing something else. And when you're not worried, you're not thinking on it, you're not dwelling on it, or sometimes in the middle of the night or in the wee hours of the morning when you just are first waking up in that twilight of time, the Holy Spirit will drop the answer to you just like that, and you'll know. I know for us, one time we had to make a decision and we were busy and we ended up going to an amusement park, just relaxed for the evening. And while we're standing in the line for a roller coaster, all of a sudden, Gary just gets from the Holy Spirit the answer. And he turns to me and goes, I just heard from God. This is what we're supposed to do. It's because we were relaxing. And so don't get stressed out if you're in a pressured situation, trying so hard to hear, trying to make a decision. Sometimes you create that environment that's so intense, you can't hear from God.
That's right.
And you need to just pray in the Spirit and trust God. Roll the care over on him. And then an hour when you think not, boom, just the Holy Spirit will give you that direction, give you that word. He'll say, don't go, don't do this, stop this. Here's the answer. Here's the direction that you're looking for.
Yes.
And you can make a great decision.
That's a great word, Drenda. Well,
listen, we don't make them under pressure, do we?
No, under pressure, because your mind's all swirling.
Yes.
That's why Jesus pulled away to a quiet place.
Yes.
Go to GaryKeesee.com. I'd love you to have this book.
Yes.
Get the information you need. GaryKeesee.com. Has all that there, as well as our mentorship program, Team Revolution. where we can help you learn more about the kingdom, how to make these right decisions. Wouldn't that be something? Obviously, that'd have a huge impact on your life. We know personally it does. GaryKeesee.com, you'll find everything there, as well as our itinerary. We travel all the time. We'd love to see you at an event. Love to shake your hand, give you a hug. But until next time, we're going to meet right here. Until next time, you remember this. God's Spirit is in you, and His thoughts are yours. The ability to hear His voice has been given to you by the Holy Spirit. Hi, I'm Gary Keesee, and you will never fulfill your destiny until you fix your money thing. Visit GaryKeesee.com, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button below. More amazing weekly videos on fixing your money thing, and thanks for watching.